Well, everybody, we're inside the historic 60-inch telescope here at Mount Wilson. Tom Meneghini's here with me. He is the executive director of this observatory and also
I'm an operator.
You're an operator?
I operated all the telescopes before I ever became a director.
What can you tell us about this 60-inch?
Well, it's actually my favorite. It's not as big as the 100-inch, but it is very nimble. It is very agile. It will go anywhere in the sky. And you can see a lot of objects in one night with this because it's very fast. This was George Willis Ritchie's crowning piece of work with this 60-inch mirror. This was the first big mirror used in astronomy. This is the granddaddy of all modern reflecting telescopes. He designed everything from the optics through the whole mechanical design.
George Ritchie did it all.
He did it all, the dome, the whole business. So he was a one-man show as far as optician, engineer, and astronomer. And this and the 100-inch are diffraction-limited telescopes.
Oh, my goodness.
Modern telescopes are not. They're atmospheric limited.
I see. So this is a Stradivarius or whatever.
Exactly.
Stradivarius,
yes.
The telescopes. I've looked through this instrument myself. I can attest that it is an amazing image. You can see incredible detail on planets.
My favorite in this is the Orion Nebula. It actually looks three-dimensional in this telescope.
God.
It's amazing.
Yeah, and they're in color too,
aren't they? Yes, you can see the
doubly
ionized oxygen.
A lot of times you can't see color in nebula with, if you're an amateur astronomer and you think you've seen nebula, you ain't seen nebula yet till you look through this thing.
You can see color, you can see magentas, you can see aquamarine colors of doubly ionized oxygen. And we have a lot of people that take pictures with their cell phones through this.
They just hold it up to the eyepiece and take a shot,
and they get amazing, amazing shots with iPhones. And I'm blown away.
It's an amazing historic instrument. I mean, Hubble was on this. Mm-hmm. Who else was on this instrument?
Harlow Shapley. He used this instrument to determine our place in the Milky Way and the size of the Milky Way with the globular clusters by measuring Cepheid variables in the globular clusters and finding that the locus of all these globular clusters wasn't around us, it was towards Sagittarius. And so that gave the hint that it was
we're
not in the center. We're not in the center, and he was able to deduce the size of the Milky Way.
Now this is used for educational outreach.
Right. This is used for birthdays, wedding proposals. We have schools up here. We have just people from JPL, from Caltech, and they're just coming here to have fun.
Right.
And they just want to see things. They want to see neat stuff. And our operators can do that. We know what to hunt for.
Well, man, oh man, I can tell you they see neat stuff through this telescope. I've seen cloud formations over Mars with it. Unbelievable images of Saturn with this telescope. It looked like it was cut out of the sky. It was incredible. Right. What are the fees, current fees to use
it's
this telescope?
For a half night, it's $1,000 for 25 people. It's a
for
deal.
For 25 people?
It's
so
a
they
deal.
Just split it up,
yes.
And it is
you
a
can't,
deal.
You can't go to a movie and a show, a movie and a dinner for that much.
That's
per person. You can't.
And this can transport you millions of light years into space. So
exactly.
You'll be doing it for real, and you'll be using something that the great astronomers used. Where do they find out more about this?
At our website, mtwilson.edu. We have both 60-inch and 100-inch reservation and schedules listed on that. And they'll be, for 2018, they'll be available in March to start reservations.
Fantastic. Great. So make your plans and come up here to Mount Wilson.